they used to draw.
Hello, art family. For this demo, I decided to do a sketch of the Tyrannosaurus Rex skeleton at the Carnegie Museum of Natural History here in Pittsburgh. I'm working on an Arches watercolor block. It's 140-pound cold-press paper, and it's in a large block. This is a 16x20 block, although I've cut in and taped across about 5 inches from the top and 1 inch from the bottom. Just because I felt like the information across the bottom of this sketch and across the very top was not really necessary to the what I thought was the most interesting or most important to the sketch. So I kind of wanted to knock those things out, just the sort of rail and emptiness in the bottom. I felt like that's distracting from what I thought was more interesting, the skeleton, of course. So I did the drawing with a yellow ochre Prismacolor, and now I'm coming back in on these things like the skull that are a little bit more complicated. I was shooting for the broad masses and big shapes, so the big shape of the skull, the big shape of the spine, treating the rib cage and the hip structure as an egg. And then I'm coming back with this red pencil to do a little bit more of the detail. I'm using the red because most of this sketch is going to be fairly gray and brown, and so I thought it would be interesting to have little pops of red here and there if some of the kind of wax colored pencil shines through. I'm also switching to kind of front-facing hand. Usually I draw reverse grip because I like to use my whole arm, especially when I'm drawing fairly large like this. And then I switch to this holding of the pencil if I'm doing some more detailed stuff. I go back and add red to the hips because I want to make sure the structure of that works as well, because if I close an eye and squint at the reference, that hip really stands out to me because it's a very light value because of the angle it's at. It's facing a window that's behind us in this photograph. So as we get into painting, just to talk about the lighting that we're dealing with here, we have a window that's like a kind of like a north-facing window. So it's not direct light coming through it. It's indirect light that's cool. So we have this cool fill light that's sort of washing across the whole room, as well as these warm spotlights all over the room. So what that means for us and for what we're working on is, and what we want to pay attention to, is that there's a gradual gradation over this whole image of warms to cools. And you don't see it quite as much in a photograph, although you can still get that sense looking at the photo. But looking at this in real life, there's a constant transition from warm to cool. Warm being closer to kind of yellow and orange, cool being more like the blues. I used yellow ochre, raw sienna, and I used lavender and some cobalt blue to work my way across the image, just getting rid of the white. That wash over the whole thing is going to be my lightest value. So think of it like the top left of the photograph. That's my lightest value. I reserved a couple spots of white, just to give some highlights. And now I'm working in the background. All of this is going to dry much lighter, but again, we have this warm wall, but it's getting washed over with cool light. So we have this subtle variation in transition from blues to warmer colors, more orangey browns, burnt siennas. I used ultramarine and burnt sienna back and forth to create a sort of optical gray. And then I added some yellow ochre or raw sienna here and there, just to get little pops showing where the warm light is hitting. In terms of structure of the image, I'm trying to forget about what I'm drawing. I'm trying to not think about this as a room that's going back into a second room and then a bigger room behind it with more dinosaurs. I'm trying to forget all that and just close an eye and squint at this photograph and go for the very basic shape. So we have that very bright, kind of very light square far back, and that lines up nicely with the jaw, so that helps with the drawing. I'm thinking of that back room as just one square in perspective and trying to find where things line up. And now I'm trying to get some texture in, and for the background and the people, I don't want to spend too much time noodling away at the specific detail, because to me, this is more about this Tyrannosaurus, so I just want to create a sort of atmosphere. Like the skeleton on the ground, I don't want to get too caught up in drawing it, although if that's something you enjoy, more power to you. Some people really love that kind of thing, getting in there and working on the details. To me, I was trying to go for the overall feeling of being in the presence of this, you know, monstrous animal. So to me, it's more about these big things. So I did less work on the background, and I'm going to let the background kind of fall away. I just want to give the sense of atmosphere and spend my time focusing on the detail and the structure of the Tyrannosaurus. We're going to pick a kind of middle light for the Tyrannosaurus. There's a complication in that there's two sides, of course, to this, the two sides of the rib cage, two sides of the skull, you know, you see through it to the interior. There's bottom planes because we're below this thing. But before I get into thinking about that, I just want to treat this thing like a silhouette. I want to make sure that my silhouette works. So we're going to go for a kind of middle light value that varies again from warm to cool. You can see that transition happening from the skull all the way to the tail. So you're going to see just subtle transitions from yellow ochre or raw sienna into a burnt sienna, ultramarine sort of gray. And what I did to sort of enhance the light is all the lower facing planes, so the beneath the jaw, the bottom of that chest plate, and the shin area on the bone, I'm going to use some green, some yellow ochre and ultramarine, leaning on the yellow ochre, because I want to add that luminescent glow as if light is strong enough to hit the ground, this grass, this sort of fake grass on the ground, and bouncing that green light back up into the lower facing planes. That's something you might see in real life that you lose in a photograph, but our eye is capable of seeing so much more color than a photograph. So I'm going to bring that in to create a more luminescent atmospheric feel. So now I have the overall structure done with this silhouette. It varies a little bit in value, but it's mostly one value across the whole thing, sort of middle light that I can come back in. I'm going to come back in with darker values to create the lower facing planes and the background parts. I'm using a little bit of a watered down mix while it's still a little wet to put in some scruffy details. In context, it'll appear that I've done a lot more work, but in actuality, I've just used a fairly dry brush with a light mix of pigment and just raked that texture across the bones to give the sense of texture. And now I'm just closing an eye at my reference and squinting the other eye, and I'm just shooting for these simple shapes. My hope is that I can focus in on these little shapes, place these little shapes of value, small triangles, small squares, little diamonds and slivers, place these dark values next to one another, always constantly comparing one shape to the next shape. Is this lighter? Is it darker? I want to place these shapes together, and then in the hopes that when you zoom back from this image, the image will become crystal clear in context. But in actuality, I'm not actually getting in there and focusing on the detail. That's another thing that I feel like, if you were really into that kind of thing, more power to you. You can get in there and really, you know, count the spinal segments and how many bones there are in the rib. I am interested in that in a sense, but not so much the detail of it as I am the overall atmospheric feeling of the presence of this, you know, giant animal. So I have the reverse side put in with the darker value, and I'm picking out these small slivers, and I feel like I'm happy with the way the Tyrannosaurus looks, and I can start to come in now and add a little bit more value to the ground to bring that forward and separate it from the background. I used white gouache and cadmium yellow, and I covered it, the Tyrannosaurus, with my notebook so that I could splatter, you know, just hitting the brush against my knuckle, splatter some light bits of value just to catch where light is hitting little pieces of the fake grass. Now I'm using clean water on a brush to just knock back some edges and adjust the value. I want my edges to be focused on the head or the skull because I find that to be the most interesting. So that's going to be it for this demo. Thanks for watching. I'll see you in the next video. In the meantime, happy sketching.